بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الحمد لله. Reading from the book Mukhtar al-Hadith, Select Prophetic Traditions by Habib Umar bin Hafiz. We are now on Hadith 32. He says, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم صدقة السر تطفي غضب الرب. حديث حسن رواه الطبراني. The messenger of God, peace and blessings be upon him, said, undisclosed charity extinguishes the wrath of the Lord. This is narrated in Tabarani, related by Abdullah bin Ja'far bin Abu Talib, and also in Al-Sat al-Tabarani by Abu Amama. This hadith tells us that private sadaqah, that is something that only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows, extinguishes the anger of our Lord. And also, sadaqah in general deflects calamities that would normally befall a person. And when you give sadaqah privately, it is actually 70 times greater than public sadaqah that you give in front of others. And the reasoning behind this is, when somebody privately gives sadaqah, then only they know, the person they're giving to knows, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows. So it's free from riyah, free from ostentation, from showing off, from doing it for the sake of people, to be known or called generous. In fact, one of the first people that is actually thrown in the hellfire is a believer who was very generous, had a lot of wealth, and gave it all out. And when he's brought before Allah, he says, Allah asked him, why did you give? And he said, I did it for your sake. And he says, kadhabt, you lied. You did it so the people would call you generous. So he did it for others and for people and so forth, and not for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah orders the angels to actually throw him into the hellfire. Allah protect us from that. And so when we do something, we do it solely and purely for the sake of Allah, and especially when it comes to charity. And thus, private sadaqah is better to do where nobody else knows, and is most likely to be free from showing off and ostentation, and greater than public sadaqah. Now, there are times like fundraising at an event where by publicly giving and giving sadaqah, that it may encourage others to give. And so that can also be encouraged in certain contexts. But as our Prophet Muhammad ﷺ tells us, that you should give out until the left hand does not know what the right hand gives. And some of the scholars explain that to mean that you're giving out so much, so often, your left hand doesn't even know what you're giving. You don't even know what you're giving. And some other scholars say that you don't even look at the amount that you're giving. You're just giving it for Allah's sake. You don't even know how much it is. Your left hand doesn't know what your right hand has given. And the Prophet Muhammad, he says that the yad al-ulya, the hand that is above, is better than the yad al-sufla, the hand that is below. So the hand that is giving out for the sake of Allah is better than the hand that is receiving. And so this is something that if we do, and we do privately, keeping it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and only He knows, then inshallah it will extinguish any wrath or anger that Allah has on us. And may Allah make us of those, inshallah, who He's pleased with, and not those that He has any anger over, inshallah, and make us those who are constantly giving out sadaqah and privately, inshallah, and gaining His pleasure and reward, and deflecting any kind of tribulations or calamities that may befall us. Wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Alhamdulillah rabbil alameen.